Hi folks, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So right when ChatGPT came out and people began to see what LLMs can do, one of the most obvious things was that they could be used as AI tutors that can give people really personalized feedback on their work and help them learn. But the devil really is in the details, and you can't just take a raw LLM that has been RLHF'd to be super helpful and give you answers right away and use it for pedagogical purposes. So 2 years in after the launch of ChatGPT, educators are finally getting some really good real-world experience in how to use large language models in educational contexts for learning and teaching. And today I want to take a look at two papers which present each their own real-world experience report. One is negative to lukewarm, and the other one is overwhelmingly positive. So let's look at both of those and what they're trying to tell us. This first one looks at using an AI tutor for an essay writing task. And as you can see from the use of the term metacognitive laziness in the title, they report a bit of a mixed picture. These were the four groups that they broke up the study population into. The control group, of course, got no intervention. There was a ChatGPT group that got ChatGPT 4.0, and it was restricted to task topics, which was essay writing. There was a human expert group where people could chat with a human expert. And finally, there was what they called an analytics or a checklist group where a tool would run a checklist against the submitted essay. What did they find? There was no difference in motivation reported by the students in any of the groups, so they were all more or less the same. In the final score for the essay itself, the AI group outperformed every other group, so that sounds like a really positive finding. However, what the authors here are tempering that with is this concept called metacognitive laziness that was in the title, which was that the AI group showed a very different pattern of what they're calling self-regulated learning compared to the other groups. So let's see in a bit more detail what they meant by that. What's the definition of this term? The authors here say that metacognitive laziness is a learner's dependence on AI assistance. And you see it when they offload metacognitive activities. And what they mean by metacognitive activities is the kinds of things that a learner would do to direct their learning with their own initiative. So things like planning the learning, pausing to reflect on how well they are learning, checking in on what they have retained, revising their work, quizzing themselves, and so on. And what they found was that the AI group basically just iterated their essay revision around ChatGPT. So just chatting, getting feedback, updating, and doing that in a tight loop. Whereas some of the other groups, notably the group that engaged with a human expert, showed more metacognitive processes, which means they did more orientation and evaluation and revision on their own. Now you might ask, what's the problem with this? Because they did find that the AI group outperformed every other group in terms of their scores on the essay, while showing more or less no difference in other variables like knowledge transfer or knowledge gain compared to the other groups. The reason the authors are stressing self-regulated learning, or as they call it, metacognitive laziness, is that there's an entire body of literature that shows that students learn much better when they are able to, as the authors say here, effectively control and monitor their own learning. So self-regulated learning is essential for learning. And that is the cautionary message that the authors here are trying to convey. Now let's look at another experience report, which provides a much rosier picture. As you can see from the title, AI tutoring outperforms active learning. The setting for this study is the physical sciences course at Harvard, which is their largest physics course with about 200 students. And this is a different task. This is not essay writing. This is the instructors trying to teach physics to the students. And there are two groups. There's one group that engaged with an AI tutor, and there's another group that participated in a live instructor-guided active learning lecture. So this is a stronger comparison because you're comparing in-person live interaction with an AI chatbot tutor. And the authors here report some really encouraging findings. The learning gains for students in the AI tutored group were over double those for students in the active lecture group. That is a pretty astounding finding. And that is with a very modest amount of time, less than an hour, that students spent with this AI chatbot. And on top of that, the students in the AI group felt significantly more engaged and more motivated than the students in the active lecture group. So the AI tutor here is putting human experts, human lecturers to shame. So then the question becomes, well, what did they do to craft such an effective AI tutor? It starts with the key principles or pedagogical goals with which they shaped this AI tutor: facilitating active learning, managing cognitive load, growth mindset, scaffolding content, we'll see what that means in a minute, ensuring the information is accurate, delivering personalized targeted feedback, and letting the students learn at their own pace. So how do you build a chatbot that meets all these key goals? And it comes down to prompt engineering and having good teachers encode some of their practices into the prompt. So for example, when you're solving large complex problems, you can't count on the LLM itself to provide enough structure. So what they did was, in the prompt itself, they broke problems down into multiple parts and asked the LLM to guide students sequentially through each part of the problem. So this was given as instruction to the LLM. It was not up to the LLM to break down the problem. To get past the problem with hallucinations, once again, they added detailed step-by-step solutions as examples to their prompts. And this worked because 83% of students said that the AI tutor's explanations were as good as or better than those from the human lecturers. So you can see that the prompt engineering is basically coming down to encoding what a good lecturer does. And the hypothesis of the authors here is that this big result of the learning rate being twice as much for the AI tutoring group comes down to the students getting personalized, immediate feedback while they're learning these concepts. And armed with the positive results they're seeing here, the authors are moving forward and trying to do the same thing with other courses. In the appendix of the paper, they give the full system prompt. And you can see here how it constructs a base persona that is friendly, supportive, and helpful. This one is pretty common by now. Do not tell them the answer. And then the scaffolding of the problem that we talked about. Only give away one step at a time, not the full solution in a single message. Assume no prior knowledge, and so on. So a lot of work and iteration went into crafting this effective prompt. So those were a couple of real-world examples of how educators are using large language models and AI tutors in real-world pedagogical solutions and seeing pretty positive results with maybe one or two cautionary notes. I hope you enjoyed that. If you like content like this, consider subscribing, like the video, and I will see you next time. Thank you very much.